Hey everybody, Green-Blooded Bastard back again. This week's podcast commentary is for the Netflix sci-fi classic. Who the fuck knows? Rebel Moon Part 1, A Child of Fire. Whatever the fuck that means. When this came out, I watched it. I don't really remember a lot about it because I know it was like a Saturday night and I was tired. And then I took my dog outside and he was being an asshole and didn't want to fucking piss. So I was outside for like 15 minutes, being a dick back to him, and I missed part of it, and it ended. So, yeah, it's gonna be fun getting back to this. The second part's out as I record this, so I'll get to that sooner than later. Anyway, sync point, first frame of black right after the Netflix logo fades to black. Press pause. I'll say 3, 2, 1, pause, and we're gonna watch this. So get ready, take a shit, go do what you gotta do, make some macaroni and cheese, whatever. I'm eating some Subway here. Eat fresh. Probably gonna give me cancer, but anyways, let's do it. 3, 2, 1, unpause. Grand Electric. That's cool, but I don't know what the fuck it means. Oh, it's a Zack Snyder's company. Stone Quarry. I heard he wants to make a fucking... What the fuck did he want to do? Fountainhead or whatever? That Iron Ryan stuff? Christ, this is low. Every time it blares my fucking ears out, this one's low. Let's turn it up. That looks like a vagina. I like it. And it's getting tore open by a angry bad guy ship. Imagery. Anthony Hopkins playing a robot. I like it. No, I'm not going to lie. I wish, you know, they would have let Zack Snyder make this into a Star Wars movie. Because, I mean, you could watch it and see elements like, yeah, this is Star Wars. Yep, this is what he's going for. You know, but it's like, think about Zack Snyder doing a Star Wars movie. Now, everybody wants to shit on him, but it's like, you know what? If you get him a good writer, you know, a good executive producer that can rein him in, support him, push him, you know, to challenge himself, you can have a pretty cool fucking Star Wars movie. I mean, at very least, for Christ's sakes, it'd be visually fucking stunning. I can't say that for some of these last Star Wars projects. Rebel Moon. A Child of Fire, Part 1. I don't think that image makes any sense from an actual visual aspect. It's cool. It was a nice transition out of space, but it don't make any sense. There's no way, even if this is a fucking moon, there's no way that would look like that in the background. I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but like, if you look at just, like, Earth and the moon and, like, you know, the photographs and shit, it's like, come on. Like, you can see it, but it's like, how many miles is that away, you know? But it's like, you just can't see shit that goddamn clear. Here's What's-His-Nuts. Wasn't that guy in Game of Thrones? Was that out of focus? That honestly looked out of focus. I mean, don't get me wrong. That's visually cool, but that looks like it's out of fucking focus. Either that or my fucking glasses are goddamn bad. I This just kind of looks shitty. I mean, I got a fucking 4K monitor here. I don't know what's going on. Maybe it's just the color. You thought. That chick's familiar too. I'm pretty sure I probably jerked off to her. I'm not sure. I don't think I did, but wasn't she the new mummy? And the Tom Cruise one? Amongst other things? Sylvia Boutella? Yep, and she was Jayla. She was that white alien with the black, like, tattoo looking things from Star Trek Beyond. Kingsman, the Secret Service. Okay. I don't necessarily remember her in that, but whatever. Argyle. Didn't see that. I really don't want to, but I'm sure my girlfriend's going to make me watch it. We got so many people in this movie. Ed Skrein, whatever his name is. The guy from Game of Thrones looking here. Michael. I might say it a little different. Huseman. Ray Fisher. Anthony Hopkins. Charlie Hunnam. Some guy named Stuart Martin that looks like fake Hugh Jackman. Oh, God, I almost died. Fuck yeah. They're gonna fuck right on that table. He's gonna get that horn right up the ass. Oh, it was fake Hugh Jackman. See, this is a serious part, folks. I just love the image of fucking ships coming down out of the sky. This is such a cool thing. Because as much sci-fi as you have, like, they very seldom show, you know, like, ships descending down to Earth. You know, or like other planets like this. Or at very least getting in like the upper atmosphere just looking badass. It's always like your little shuttles and stuff that aren't imposing. I did. Dropship. See, like, you know, they're still coming down in a dropship, but it's like, imagine if there was like a Star Destroyer in Star Wars. And I think in those sequel ones, you kind of saw, like, granted, there was like in Revenge of the Sith, there was the battle in the upper atmosphere, but like, I think in the sequel trilogy, there might be a shot in one of them. With the ships coming in. I must remember from a cartoon or something, but it's like, I mean, imagine if there's a fucking Star Destroyer, like the size of those fuckers, hovering in upper atmosphere, like just above, like fucking Washington, D.C. or something. You'd be like, holy fuck. You know, like, District, what is it? Fucking District, 9 or 10 or 11 or 8 or whatever the fuck it is. 26. Like, that had that ship hovering, like, over a city. Which is cool. Like, that's imposing as fuck. But it's like, that was just hovering there. You know, we didn't see it show up and then send fuckers down. This just has a weird look to it. Like, what the fuck? I mean, I guess I didn't necessarily notice it the first time I watched this. But, like, kind of around the edges. Like, even, like, those back top houses are kind of, like, out of fucking, like, out of focus. Like, a blur to them. I'm assuming it's a stylistic choice with being, you know, like, on a moon. Close to a fucking planet, the light's different, you know, and shit, whatever, but I don't know, it's just weird, it's distracting. Yeah, just the edges of this whole thing, man. Like, I don't know. It just looks like out of fucking, like a blur. It almost looks like if you watch like a 3D movie without fucking 3D glasses on at times. Like, I don't know what the fuck is going on here. Now, I think both those guys, Ed Skrein and the other guy over his left shoulder, didn't they play the same character in Game of Thrones? They kicked out fucking Eddie here for the other guy? I think so. It's been a while and I really don't care. but I'm pretty sure they played one. This fuck stick right here got turned into MODOK. Are you kidding me? That was like the worst CGI I've ever seen. What's his name, like Corey Stahl or something? He's good. He was enjoyable in House of Cards, the American version. I've seen him in other things. But that's the first thing I always go to. He's always enjoyable. But he was pretty fun in there. Got what was coming to him. That's an annoying sound. Look at that haircut. He just looks like a fucking twat. Love him. Like, all there's just guys there in, like, white shit. They're, like, the red robes and stuff. There's your lightsaber. And he's a space Nazi. I like this robot design, it's pretty cool. That guy just looks like a fucking rapist. Oh, okay, yeah. Shouts aggressively, makes kissing noise. He's like, is a space horse taking a shit. You guys just look like twats. Yeah, his robot design was cool because it's like, you know, it's very similar, obviously, to everything we've seen because, God forbid, we're fucking bipedal humanoid-shaped creatures and no one's got any sort of imagination when it comes to sci-fi, but it's a cool design because it's, you know, it's not as, like, strong-looking as some. Like, she's just out of focus. What the fuck? But, you know, obviously he's armored up and was a battle droid of some sort. But, yeah, just, like, his armor is cool looking. Issa. She's gonna fucking blow that robot. Did you see that look? Jesus Christ. God damn. Nah, just like, look at that cool detail on his armor. Like, that, not only does it give him character and make his, you know, body look cool, it's like, it shows, you know, like, the wealth and majesty, you know, of, you know, like, this empire when the king was there, you know, and alive. Just because why would you put that much time and craftsmanship in a machine that in all to, you know, all reality would just be destroyed, you know, in battle or something, or wrecked just from combat, you know, because they cared about beauty as much as utility, you know. Jesus. Not till I split this sapling myself. There we go. Here's a fucking 40-minute slow motion fucking fight scene. Good old sand in the eye, it'll never fucking get old. And it'll always work. There's the King of the Hill thing when Dave Grubb was always like, pocket sand, and then throw it at people's face and shit. Beautiful. I'm gonna show it and show it. I know it's not like a normal gun, so it's probably just burning them. Like probably plasma or something, but. But it would be great. But it would have been cool just to show some blood. It was just a silly-looking run. Better than the way I can run, but still, it was just a silly-looking run for a fucking robot.
All this guy does is just tie scenes together by his ridiculous dialogue.
Belisarius.
Like, I love how every bullshit sci-fi thing. Has like some sort of bullshit like religious aspect to it. Now, granted, that makes sense to a degree, because how else do you control people? Bullshit religion, you know what I mean? We do it on our planet quite often, all the time, and have been doing it. That's why we're so fucking stupid. People believe that trash, but it's like all these things. There's always like religious shit, you know, and it's like, well, can we just get to the point where we realize, you know, maybe if we hit starfaring age and we can travel from planet to planet, religion doesn't matter and we're over it. Because, you know, they got that bullshit and, I mean, fuck, like, Stargate, the whole fucking thing is premised on, you know, aliens that created a religion to fucking, you know, stay in power and enslave people. You know, we got that Chronicles of fucking Riddick movie with those fucking guys. You know, what was the last, I mean, you look at Dune, you know, there's the fucking Bene Gesserit or whatever, you know, those religious whack jobs that were just in power and controlling people, manipulating shit. What's that one fucking comic? Where the fucking, what's it called? Like the Techno Priest or whatever? I forget what the fuck it's called. But I mean, it's like, and it's just everywhere. It's like, can we just not have religious shit?
Kind of looks like a guy I used to work with like 15, 16 years ago. You know, I don't know exactly what the budgets for these two movies were. But, I mean, they look pretty fucking good. I mean, I'm sure they were, like, decent size. You know, they probably weren't, like, small. But, I mean, honestly, for a movie like this, for the kind of story they're trying to tell, I'm sure they were probably pretty modest. Versus fucking like Star Wars, which is like, you know, probably 180 to 250 million a fucking movie. I mean, this says, obviously, this is, you know, just what's reported, but I don't know how accurate it is, but it says 166 million budget for filming both parts. So, I mean, you're about, what, 84 million each, give or take, you know? I mean, four hours worth of movie for that much, plus they're doing those extended, so it means they shot, like, probably 5 hours, 6 hours worth of fucking movie shit, you know, depending on how extended they are. So it's like I said, I mean, like, can you imagine what he could do with a fucking huge budget running around in the Star Wars fucking, you know, back lot here with the money and the fucking resources that fucking Disney and Lucasfilm has. I think you get some truly crazy looking shit. Oh, Christ. Oh no, that's our guy. Like, you can see, like, definitely a cool, you know, like, old western slash, you know, oriental inspired, you know, feel of this town. No idea what the fuck that is. That's how you get COVID, folks. Oh, God. Is that, I don't know the guy's name. Fuck me. Oh, God. I wish I knew his name. I think I might have to. Jenna Malone is in here. I gotta look at the whole cast. I hate when IMDb only gives me like the top 3-4 guys. Corey Stoll, yeah. Is that him? Nope, don't know who the fuck that is. Nah, these fucking pictures are so small. This is a cool little idea here. I love it. I swear to God, that guy looks fucking familiar. I can't fucking find it. I swear to God, it's going to drive me fucking nuts. Because I think it's this guy that I can picture him, but I just can't. I can't fucking get it.
Just like Bounty Hunters.
Dominic fucking Burgess. That had to have been the guy. Fucking Charlie Hunnam. Here you go, slumming it. I say slumming it, but honestly, he just does whatever trash he gets paid for. Yeah, he usually does a good job, but... I think he's a bit overrated. I mean, I like them on Sons of Anarchy, but I don't know, he was kind of a bitch on there. It's always fun, but I think his charisma gets him farther than just raw talent. I think he would have been a better Christian Grey, because I think wasn't he cast originally? As him backed out because too many people were going crazy. It's like, oh yeah, turn that roll down, you fuck nugget. I thought he was gonna put that on his dick or something at first. I was like, oh, sci-fi. Some weird fucking eel sex shit. I remember this. This is like the Harry Potter moment of this fucking movie. Don't they fucking fly something around? Or, I don't know, they do something. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's fucking Buckbeak back there. Train and protect us. This guy's like a human version of Beetlejuice. You should ask, can you break them? Like, this is a cool scene, but it's kind of pointless. You know, it's just a side trip that, you know, you need in movies like this, but it's just like, you know, unless they're gonna be flying, you know, Thestrals like this, or whatever the fuck they're called, in a big climactic battle, it seems, I mean, a bit over pointless just to show that he's a badass. Oh, it's like the kind of shit my dog would do just to be an asshole. That little fucker. Slow motion running. I don't know if a jump like that would get you on top necessarily, but okay. It looks cool with the silhouette of the sun, you know, and the outline of his body like that, but
He's like, oh, we're blood brothers, bro.
Atta girl. And it's like, at least they could have ripped his fucking heart out and just like pecked at it or something. Like, that would have been a fucking good button to that scene.
Isn't this the planet from fucking, what was that fucking Star Wars game? Oh God, wasn't it, Fallen Order? Wasn't that the planet he was on? Working scrap? I think so. Belt. To quote John Malkovich's character from Transformers 3, WTF to that. Oh, that's Wutzerfuck. That's the chick from Hunger Games I mentioned before. Jesus Christ. That was a ridiculous look he gave. Now, in theory, this is a cool concept for a fight, but it's like, it's just, it's not that imposing. And it doesn't actually make her look that good. And one more question, why wouldn't you use those to begin with? Just gonna throw that out there. This doesn't need to be this long. You could have did a cool fucking fight where you just... She tries to be the fucking... The diplomat. It doesn't work, so she just... She digs these fuckers out, does a crazy fight, kills this thing, looks like a badass. He's like, nah, I saw the way you fought. That wasn't that good. Is that a King Corso or whatever those are?
Oh, fuck, I am tired.
Divine Resonance. What a fucking subtitle. You know, they talk about this fucking war, but it's like, you know, it'd be great to see the fucking war. Like, it'd be great to see the war. Like, can we get a film of that? Or an animated series or whatever the fuck we're gonna do? That fucking hat on. God damn it. That image looked like it was just fucking like stretched or something weird.
dissect his brain.
I just have a feeling, like, that's just how he acts on a daily basis. Just as a human being, like a real Ed Screen, like, just walk around all cocky as fuck, just kill the guy, just like, fuck it. I played a vampire hybrid thing in Blade 2, fuck you. Oh, Christ, I'm fucking tired. Ugh. That's definitely a weird fucking alien. Oh, is that, what's the name? Ray Fisher or whatever? Must be. Our business, a revolution. Ah, fuck. It would have been great if they just would have cut to a guy, like, standing, like, a little back to the left. He's like, oh, shit. That would have been great. I'll go, bro. Gerba. Like, well, maybe it is suicide. Dog-headed son of a bitch. This fucking guy. Unregistered Trade Depot. Okay. That's a nice little sound effect.
Good. You can come be a farmer with me.
Oh, shit. Oh, fucking piss. I think the beginning of this is like where I fucking went outside the last time with my dog. Because then I came home or came back inside and I was like, what the fuck is going on? My girlfriend's just like, I have no fucking idea. It's like, okay, thanks for paying attention for me. Oh, God, shit's hitting the fan already. I see it's barely gone. Yes, you will. There's your slow motion shit. I haven't had that in fucking 5 minutes. I will say he didn't overuse it in here compared to some stuff. Like, you know, it's in here a lot, but it's not like over slow motion. It's not like used for whole sequences and montages. That didn't look safe. I wonder, like, I just see if they ever, like, came out with a book, like, the making of these two movies. That'd be almost worth buying. Because, I mean, they definitely put a lot of thought into some of this world building and shit, and design. But I'm just wondering if that's, like, an actual bone from something, or if it's just, you know, a sticker, stone carved to look like bone. Don't do it, bro. This is like the slowest looking. You can tell he's on a fucking treadmill the way he's running here. Because I don't know how he would run like that without being on a treadmill. Come on. He's like, that's my fucking ship. He's like, you bitch. You know, that was just a great close combat, you know, where she's kind of stuck, so she just punches him. And it's great because he just, like, punches her right fucking back. Like, it wasn't stylized, it was just down and dirty, like, motherfucker, and then a quick punch. Punch right in the fucking dick. Okay, and that light looks metal. Yeah, it sounded like metal. Okay. He's just a weirdo. Don't worry, he'll be back, motherfuckers. He's a villain. They don't let him die. Just a shot of teeth fucking flying. I love it. I just walk around without a fucking shirt on. That's pretty lucky that it just wrapped around three times and then spun around the fucking cord. A fallen prick officer of his men. Those space horses that like to take a shit. It'd be great if, like, just off in the distance, you see the fucking... the robot running, you know, like, ah, he's still freaking out, like, months later. Except here he's got fucking antlers on and he's a fucking crazy guy. It would have been great just to see him running around like, hey, I killed him. Like, what's he doing just wandering around? This is some Star Wars shit. It's a fucking back to tank. That was big fucking fish under the ice. It's just like, did he make it back? Well, that's the end. That's the way to end it.
End part one, bitch.
Holy fuck. Well, folks, that's all she wrote on that one, I guess. Yeah. We'll be back for another one at some point. Thanks for listening.